An entire generation of Azerbaijanis has now grown up listening to this hateful rhetoric. This rhetoric escalated before and during the September-November 2020 armed conflict. And regrettably, it was Azerbaijan's highest-ranking official, President Ilham Aliyev, who set the tone. His dehumanizing metaphors, equating Armenians to dogs, became a rallying cry during the conflict, showing, in the words of a commentator, the degree of hostility and hate speech within Azeri society. But the presidential hate speech did not stop with the end of Azerbaijan's aggression in November 2020. Month after month, it continues to this day. For example, in December 2020, President Aliyev characterized Armenians as the despised and savage enemy, and as aliens to the region. In January this year, he claimed that Armenians have no moral values and cautioned his compatriots to not be likened to them. In February, he stated that Armenians cling to other countries like elites. In March, he declared that Armenians are sick, ravaged by a virus worse than the coronavirus. In April, while proudly inaugurating the military trophies park, he suggested that savage is perhaps too soft of a word to describe Armenians. Later that same month, he called the United States government's recognition of the Armenian genocide unacceptable and a historic mistake. In May, he referred to Armenians as barbarians, who destroyed and plundered the land like a wild tribe, and declared that these people cannot build a state. These people can only live within other large states. In June, he claimed that the whole world knows that the first Armenian state was established on Azerbaijan's historical land. In July, he reiterated that Armenians have no historical basis for living there, meaning Nagorno-Karabakh. In August, he found vandalism to be inherent in Armenians. In September, he once again proclaimed that Armenians have a mental illness and are a deprived and impertinent tribe. A mere 10 days ago, he stated that the Armenian nation has nothing to do with the Caucasus, and that Armenians are settlers there, and everyone knows where they came from. Madam President, members of the court, it is said that hate speech is in the ear of the beholder. You will read President Aliyev's speech in their entirety, and you will appreciate for yourself the context in which these statements were made. You will also discover the obvious answer. These are not a mere expression of controversial ideas or opinions. These are incitement to hatred, contempt, violence, or discrimination, plain and simple. They are the continuation of a hateful rhetoric that has been ongoing for years. The problem, of course, is not just President Aliyev's rhetoric. Anti-Armenian hate speech is by no means limited to him. The problem is that it is this official discourse that shapes the viewpoints of Armenians of generations upon generations of Azerbaijanis. Why? Because President Aliyev's grip on Azerbaijan is absolute, and this is putting it mildly. Freedom House ranks Azerbaijan as not free, and among the lowest scoring countries in terms of its citizens' civil liberties and political rights. Human Rights Watch has noted that all mainstream media are under tight government control. As a result, there is no counterpoint to anti-Armenian hate. Activists working on promoting dialogue between the Armenian and Azerbaijani society societies are routinely arrested and sentenced on false charges of high treason, as the European Court of Human Rights has recently found. This discourse shapes and feeds upon an environment that openly glorifies and rewards abhorrent crimes against Armenians. The image on your screens is from a stamp proudly issued by Azerbaijan to commemorate the major events of 2020, namely its fight against the coronavirus and war of aggression against Nagorno-Karabakh. The image depicts a disinfection specialist standing over a map of Azerbaijan and fumigating an area in dark green color. That area is Nagorno-Karabakh, as well as the southern parts of Armenia. The message is clear. Ethnic Armenians are a virus in need of eradication. The references to ethnic cleansing are so blatant that the Universal Postal Union declined to register the stamp and invited Azerbaijan to withdraw it. Another notorious example of glorification of anti-Armenian hate is the case of Lieutenant Ramil Safarov. Instead of serving the life sentence he was originally given in Hungary for the brutal murder of his Armenian colleague attending the same NATO English language course in Budapest in 2004, upon his extradition to Azerbaijan, Safarov was pardoned, promoted to the rank of major, and given a flat, and all of his wages lost since his arrest. He was labeled as an exemplary model of patriotism for the Azerbaijani youth by no less than the human rights defender of Armenia, of Azerbaijan, my apologies. Recently, the European Court of Human Rights found all these actions to be racially motivated by an animus against ethnic Armenians. The CERD committee, for its part, noted that, quote, by welcoming a citizen of Azerbaijan convicted of murdering an Armenian as a national hero, and by pardoning and releasing that person upon transfer, Azerbaijan condones racial hatred, hate crimes, and denies redress to victims.